once again to our live unboxing. I'm Logan, and this is Tang Garden by Thundergriff Games. We're going to be opening it up, taking a look at it today, and seeing exactly what's inside. I know a lot of other reviewers have been receiving it recently, so there's been a lot of pictures going around on Facebook of it, and we're going to get to our review of it afterwards. Just want to do an unboxing video so that everybody can see exactly what's inside of it. So let's go ahead and get a little description. You can see on the front right here, it's got a little sticker that I don't know how well you can see that on the camera, but it says, you know, you buy this game, you're going to plant a tree. So, you know, because it's a wonderfully beautiful visual game. I'm getting notifications on my phone because people want to start writing me whenever I go live. Always it happens. I'm not going to write them back, but I am going to try to keep aware of my Twitch chat while I'm live streaming. For some reason it says I'm not live streaming on Twitch, which I should be. So if anybody can actually see me and they are on Twitch, go ahead and give me a little wave, say hello. I should be on Facebook also. Okay, now it says that I'm live on Twitch. All right, Tang Garden by Thundergriff Games. Let's go ahead and get a little description from the back of it real quick. You can see here, it is the Tang Dynasty, 1618 to 907. It is considered the first golden age of the classical Chinese garden. Emperor, I'm not even going to try because I'm going to butcher it, built a magnificent imperial garden, the Garden of the Majestic Clear Lake near Zhang, I'm thinking it is, I'm not sure, and lived there with his famous concubine, Yang. I'm just going to butcher names all over the place, so I'm not even going to try. Anyway, so players, you take on the role of engineers who have been summoned to build a garden while balancing elements of water, rock, and greenery. They need to decorate the garden with pavilions, bridges, different types of vegetation, and animals such as birds and goldfish. During the construction, characters will visit the garden and inspect how the natural elements are arranged and admire the surrounding landscapes. So this game, you can see right here, is for ages 14 and up, 1 to 4 players, and it plays at about 45 minutes. You see all the game components, they got a whole list here, and this picture you can see, it's a bunch of 3D stuff. Yeah, I've been seeing the pictures online. People have been having stuff all over the place with this, so let's go ahead and bust into this real quick. Always make sure if you're using a knife to close it afterwards. You do not want to injure yourself on your knives at all. So let's get this going on. Also, excuse my voice a little bit. I'm a little congested. I hope I'm not getting sick. I hope everybody else is staying safe during this time we've got going on of illness and the virus. Please take care of yourself. Please take care of your health. Side with all the rest of my plastic I do for my unboxings. All right, and let's go ahead and get this level. This is a really big, heavy box, just so everybody knows. It's not just a box for the lighthearted. No. All right. Punch boards can be found below the insert. Awesome. Dear Architect, thank you for your interest in Tang Garden. In the box, you'll find all the punch boards of the game below the insert. After the tokens have been punched out, you can place the frames back underneath the insert to give some structural support to the tray. That's always nice. I always like that because sometimes the inserts are just bad and flimsy, and or you're left with, you know, huge gaps of space on top of the box, and then your stuff in your insert just slides around or jumps out, depending on how you have to jumble it around. And it also says, by buying this game, you're also planting a tree. The Forest Garden Program is a simple, replicable, and scalable approach with proven success. Yeah, so they're going to plant a tree for every copy of the game bought. So that's awesome. I always like to make myself symmetrical. So this flips over here there. Looks like we have the rule book here. And it shows all the different minis and everything on there right on the front as pictures, not just as a list, which it had on the back of the box. And that shows you, yep, complete setup. Order of Play, Build the Garden. Yeah, and this is, these are really, really beautiful. So just flip through the rule book real quick. You got scoring, it's got a solo variant, yin and yang, so you how to set that up. And then on character descriptions for all the characters in the game. On the back of the book. So flip it there. So this is where we start getting into the meat of it. This is the board. And a lot of stuff in here, like I said, is 3D. It's actual, like, miniatures, not just, like, flat pieces to use. Let me get this board open, like, here. Yeah. You see, it's a pretty plain gray and white and brown board with the colors for the different players. Like, blue, orange, green over there, and white. Over here, so you see the board and where it's gridded, where you'll be setting stuff up. Little koi fish floating around with some lotus blossoms going on, and little divots in the board, probably to insert stuff later on. Let's go ahead and stick that board over there. We got some character boards floating around over here. These are the minis. You see them in there. They actually come in a little case. So this actually is nice. Usually you have minis just like floating around in there, or you got to figure out your own space to put them. But this is actually in a little case here. I like that. That's nice. As well as separated out pieces. Oh, we're gonna have to start building stuff. Well, I'm not gonna do it right now on camera, but I got tokens, little circular tokens here. And then these look like house pieces, either floors or roofs. And then, roofs here. Because we're going to be building stuff, and then they'll all fit in here afterwards. Maybe they're like little walls. And these, I suspect, are the player boards. Yeah, they match the colors on the board. Okay, yellow, green, blue, and red right there. The little divots. Don't exactly know what they are yet, but I will after I'm done reading the rule book. But these are nice. These are nice and thick. Barely bendable. Awesome. Cards. Oh, and more cards. So nice art roll. Then get the glare off of there. Nice art. We can see it says fish up there with some little look like scoring things. We're going to have to figure out what those are and what happens. And these are probably the roles of the players. This would be the architects building the things. He's got them there. Actually, without having to get the knife back out, I can actually open these up. Yeah, oh, here we go. Different colors. Come on, focus camera. Yeah, architect, child, emperor, empress, hermit, lady, merchant, monk, officer, poet, student, sword dancer. So these are probably relate to the different minis that we have here. I think, if I remember correctly, it said something about players are going to have to be exploring on the garden with the different people and scoring points like that. So maybe they have certain things that they actually like. On the bottom, you see a little scoring things. And once again, we'll go through all that during our review of the game. All right, and now all the punch boards will be underneath the insert here, which I have to say is still a nicely built insert. It has room for all the different things, and then we'll have put the punch boards back underneath after we are done. To be able to lift it up so it's not just like sitting, because without the punch boards, you put it back into the box, you're gonna be, if I can actually get it in there, maybe you don't need it. Oh, but it's still gonna be like wobbly on the bottom because you don't have anything supporting underneath of it, and so kind of like it can indent in, you can get punctures on the edge of it. So putting these punch boards after you're done with them underneath provides a lot more stability in keeping the bottom of it straight. So let's move that stuff out of the way so we can take a look at these punch boards. We'll put them diagonal here. It's got all the tokens. It looks like more stuff for building with the roofs and the walls and the floors. It's probably money tokens, some other tokens there. These all decided, yeah. Remember, you're going to be building the best garden that you can. So it's got all these different tiles. Sometimes it's good for me just to shut up and actually show the stuff instead of talking all the time. So this actually works out right here. Oh, yeah. Really, really nice. Especially the trees. So, yeah. So I got a lot of punching out to do and figure out where everything goes to get organized in the box again. And grab the rule book right here. Nice. All right, so this is Tang Garden by Thunder Griff Games. And, yeah, for each one you buy, they're going to plant a tree, or they're working with a program to plant a tree. Looks really, really nicely made, and it just looks wonderful. I'm going to have to punch out a bunch of this. So stay tuned for some pictures as I'm doing it on our Instagram and also Twitter, what have you. So, yeah, and then... we'll see you next time. We got more unboxings coming. We got some more Kickstarter videos and some reviews that are coming up. I know we're a little backed up on reviews and stuff, but we're trying to punch them out as quickly as we can. Yes, so go ahead and give us a like on the video if you're watching this after the live stream. Go ahead and give us a like, share it around so everybody can be aware of Tang Garden and watch for our review. So I'm Logan for Logan Chops Reviews Unboxings. And as always, happy gaming. We'll see you guys next time.